when you are civilized, you accept the existence of God and you know that you cannot take everything to be granted, just like the law of the state, we know how it is controlled. Similarly, you cannot control the planets, you cannot control seasons. So these are all happening by higher arrangement. So generally what they conclude, this atheistic class of people, is that there is no controller. But in the Bhagavad Gita, it is saying Maya Dakshena Prakriti. The Prakriti, this material nature, is controlled by a controller. Otherwise, how every day from the sun comes from the east and sets in the west without any arrangement? There is a nature which is working so systematically. So how can be there something atheistic view? We have heard some stories about some scientists like Newton. He had an atheistic friend and he used to always argue, where is God, where is God? There were theistic scientists also like Newton, Einstein. They were all theistic scientists. They used to believe in God. Not that because they learned some mathematical formulas, they will not say there is no God. They all were believers of God. They used to say, we are doing scientific research to understand God. So Newton one day invited his friend to his laboratory. And when his friend entered the laboratory, he saw a model of a solar system. It was all floating. The planets were moving and sun is there, and earth is there. Very beautiful made model. So then Newton came from his inner chamber and he greeted his friend. So his friend asked, very beautifully done, Newton. Very nice. This arrangement of this solar system is very nicely arranged. So Newton said, I don't know how this came up. It came automatically. So his friend said, hey, you are joking. How this can come automatically? You have made and you have kept the model, and why are you saying that it came automatically? So Newton said, no. In the night I slept, I kept all the particles here and I slept. Morning I got up, I saw everything is automatically became solar system. So Newton then told, when his friend didn't agree finally, so he told, you see, for my solar system model itself, if it requires a scientist behind it working, for the real solar system to exist, without a supreme scientist, is it possible for it to exist like that? So this is what, how there were theistic real scientists who knew that this whole world cannot be controlled without any mathematical equations, how, without any formulas, because everything is so systematic in this world. You can state the theory of thermodynamics means what, how things work in this world. If cricket ball is thrown in a particular amount of speed, what time it will go and reach to the cricket bat, and how, when he is hitting, at what force it is going, means it can, everything is, we can calculate. There are mathematical equations. So science is worked on equations. It's like Newton was sitting and was suddenly one day apple fell on his head. Then he understood, oh, there is something running, and he made the theory of gravity. Not that because Newton made that formula, then this equation started of gravity. There is always gravity. But one day Newton found out that there is something theory and he made that formula. Similarly, the scientist who is making this formula, when he does the discovery, he knows that he has not invented that. So that's why they used to call discovery. It is already existing. I am not newly making anything. This is real science. The Vedic science was always filled with theism,